Hey, what's happening, gamers? Welcome to the start of a new Let's Play on our Let's Play channel, and we're taking a look at the new adventures of Batman the Animated Series. Woo-hoo! And its game, Batman Vengeance, which came out in 2001 for the GameCube, PS2, and the Xbox. Of course, it features the voice talents of Kevin Conroy, Mark Hamill, Tara Strong, Arlene Sorkin... I forget the rest.
Arlene!
I don't know. And, of course, the guy who played Mr. Freeze, lady who played Poison Ivy. Although Catwoman isn't in this game.
Aw, sadness.
Yes.
No!
And you can see the art style is based after the spin-off series of the animated series. And the CG is actually very good for this game. For, you know, being 10, 11 years ago.
Yep, it is very good.
I love this scene. It's so cool. Eye slant.
I love that little eye slant. So classic.
I hated that costume, though.
Really?
I'm a fan of the bat emblem, that yellow on the chest.
I don't like the whole
40s look.
And you like the yellow.
The target.
So
a girl
know.
To die for.
So the thugs have something to aim for.
Oh yeah, this is an old game. We have to adjust the brightness now. Let's see, do I want it dark or light? Dark or light? Let's try that. I can kind of see what I'm doing. Cape glide! Skadoosh. You can see the cape animation is actually pretty cool.
Oh, I love that cape glide. That's really cool.
Very sleek.
Do it again!
Yay!
Oh, it's so cool! Yeah, it's so cool. Like, even when you're standing, it like your cape gets like... I don't know, it just goes on the ground, it looks all cool.
Yeah, and I always go over to these buildings over here. This is the way to do it. Because if you go down there, you end up running like this little maze and you get lost. Because you can't access this area right here.
Yeah, that would be me. I would totally get lost.
I always used to stroll at this point, like, I'm in no hurry. Girl's tied to a bomb. What do I care? I'm Batman! And he just walks up to her anyway.
Casually.
How's it going? Bomb. Hmm?
Oh.
Wait, watch, he picks her up and he's like, dum-de-dum! Let's stroll away.
Yeah, you would think he'd go a little faster.
Run, Batman, run! I love how the credits appear. Like, right.
Oh, that is cool. That just appears at the very beginning, or...
Yeah. What's funny is this... is, of course, based after the New Adventures, but the New Adventures was off the air by this point, and Justice League was starting.
Interesting.
But this game came out for PlayStation 2 first.
That would have been cool if it came out when, you know, the animated series was in full.
Well, the animated series and New Adventures have the most video games associated to their name than any other Batman franchise.
Wow, that just shows how cool they are.
Oh, yes. There you can see the awesome cape animation again. Especially in CG, it's like this kind of spawn cape. It's like alive.
Oh, wow. That's...
Yeah. Ah, 3D. Not really. And Joker somehow survived that.
3D for back when it was cool for us.
I hated that Joker look. Without the, you know, red... lip thing.
Yeah, what's
I hated
up with that?
That.
You ran out of lipstick?
Looked like the Screaming Mimes or something instead of the Joker. Didn't work. This game has some detective elements, but not really. So I'm just going to clam up so we can hear Mark Hamill. So cool to hear the cast in this.
Yeah, I'm really I did not know that they had a game like this. Like, you know, with a cast kind of like, voice acting cast like Arkham City. It's like amazing.
Yep. Well, Kevin Conroy doesn't remember doing this game or Rise of Sinzu, so that's not a good thing.
He doesn't doesn't remember doing
No, he was like, this is the first time I've really voiced a video game. It's like, what about Batman on Sega Saturn and... Or Sega CD and Batman Vengeance and Sinzu. It's like, oops.
Did someone hypnotize him and force him to voice it? No.
It's the Joker. And maybe more. Something about this woman doesn't add up. I'm gonna work.
Your lips don't add up.
Run Alfred's training program for me.
Sure thing.
Now, what's interesting about this continuity is, of course, Batgirl is his partner. So this takes place after Dick has left to establish himself in another city, or just taken off completely. Because there's no mention of Robin, Tim Drake, in this at all. So I'm guessing this game takes place before Tim Drake becomes Robin and before Dick Grayson comes back to Gotham City as Nightwing. So Batman has teamed with Barbara Gordon, and they have that kind of, you know, I don't know what their thing would be. It wouldn't be the dynamic duo. I don't know the term. And you can see the Batcave that we're looking at is straight out of the animated series incarnation. Like, you can see the water below. The Batboat would be down there. Batcomputer is the same as it is. The only difference is, because this is such an older game, there's really not much in the cave at all. It's just,
it's there.
But
it's,
I love the
bare bones.
Yeah, I love the cel shaded look.
Me too.
And there is the other incarnation of the Batmobile. Not my favorite. I like the first animated series incarnation. A lot of people say, why don't you like the New Adventures? It's like, I'm actually going to do a video why I didn't like it. I love the fact Nightwing was in it, but some other things just really bugged me about issues with it.
Yeah.
Still fun to watch.
Yep.
Trust you will find it useful. We'll begin with a bit of bat grapple training.
My favorite Alfred.
If you'll be so kind as to activate the grapple.
And this is just a tutorial. You can see it showing us how to do it. And, you know, back then, games kind of just had a little tutorial level. But today it's like every checkpoint, every part of the game you go to, it's like you learn a new element of the game. Back here it was all taught in the first, 15-minute level. Which I still hated, because they didn't really do that in NES games or Super Nintendo. It was N64, GameCube, PS2.
Yeah, it's like back in the day, your training wheels came off after the first tutorial level. Mm-hmm. Now it's like
every new gadget, it's like, oh, do this and this, and to activate this combo, do this, and it's like constant. It's so annoying.
And a handful of batarangs, you probably could render a grown man unconscious, but it is a bit wasteful.
Yeah, you actually have stock ammunition in this, so Alfred's saying you can knock a guy out with the batarangs, but it's a bit wasteful. Mm. And it actually lets you do that. The batarangs have a purpose. You can knock a gun out of a guy's hands and things like that.
With a little practice, you can strafe around your target without losing your...
Alfred, be quiet. I'm trying to get a thought out here. So, I mean, it was interesting. The controls for this were a little bit... I don't know. I'm trying to think why I praised this game so much when I did my Batman month in 2008.
Very good, Master Bruce. Perhaps now we should brush up on your fisticuffs.
Okay. Alfred needs to fall into a river in the middle of a Lego lake.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, you have a wide variety of the martial arts at your disposal.
No, we don't want to kill Alfred.
You may find some of your opponents are
I'm sorry.
No, I'm just annoyed with his voice.
There are few men in the world as
skilled. He does a great job, though.
Oh, great voice actor. I'm just, this is so boring.
So much of this.
Yeah. It's like, it's showing me exactly how to play it. Now, you can't really do any combos here. You just have to punch the pole. During the game, you'll unlock various combos and things like that. And like I said in my, other things for this game, I will be using cheats just because it's more fun, and I've already beaten this game.
Nicely done, Master Bruce.
It's more fun to cheat.
Yeah, but the reason why I said this game was probably so good, back in 2007 when I was recording the footage, I was still playing a lot of GameCube games, so I was very familiar with the controls. Picking this game up again recently and playing it right now, the camera seems a little bit buggy to me. The controls are a lot slower than I'm used to for Arkham City and some of the other Batman games.
Yeah.
And the camera work is just... ugh.
But it's like back in the day, it was really cool though.
Yeah. Well, yeah, this was like.
And it still is pretty cool, but.
It's very cool to look at. But you can just see how dated the visuals are, like the pixelation and things like that.
And you realize how far games have come.
Mm-hmm.
It is, like, very bare bones. Yeah, well, go ahead.
This is 10 years ago, and if you compare it to games today, the only difference with games today is the backgrounds are enhanced, the character models are a little bit better, but there's mm-hmm. not this monster leap from GameCube to, say, PS3. It's subtle tweaks.
Right.
It's not like going from, say, 16-bit to 64.
Right. This one
to perfect. Not saying that that's not going to happen. It's not going to happen with this coming generation, because they already said that for the Wii U, PS4, and 720.
Yep.
So we're still just getting subtle tweaks. It's like basically when the Atari would just make a little bit better version of the same console over and over again. It gets old. That's why you have to change up the control mechanic. So instead of the joystick for Atari, Nintendo went with a gamepad.
Yeah, gotta keep it exciting and fresh.
You gotta change the gameplay mechanics
like,
to keep people...
this is really cool. It's new.
Yep. Yeah. And that was, of course, the diving thing that you have to do.
Wonderful, sir.
It's kind of a mini-game. Not really. That completes our training. Good, shut up.
Sadness.
Find
poor
anything?
Alfred.
Questions with no answers.
Try me.
Well, Toby was reported kidnapped to the police 4 days ago. Before that, nothing. Didn't go to school. Wasn't even born. Same goes for Mary. I've got an address on the apartment she just moved into, and that's it.
That's impossible. Nothing else at all?
Not a thing. I don't know if you can save these people, Batman. They're already ghosts.
Bum, bum, bum!
Yeah.
Yeah, the story for this game is very weak. I mean, it was an interesting original tale back then, but both this and Sinzu is just kind of like...
Yep.
Mark's funny, though.
Yeah, I was just going to say, now it should get interesting.
Take a break and play a while, doodah, doodah. Guarantee I'll make you smile, oh, the doodah day.
Yay!
Not now, Pooh. My audience who waits. After that, we're home free. Our friend in tights takes the bait, takes a dive, and then we string him up and drop him in the drink. Any questions?
Yeah, well, boss, a couple of guys and I were thinking that since we're fighting the bat and all that, maybe we're not getting paid as much as we should.
Uh-oh.
I mean, when I was working for the Penguin, we were getting benefits in a 401k.
Ooh.
Hmm.
Well, now you're working for Mr. J, you chowderhead. You'll do what he says and take what he gives and hope it is not a bullet.
Baby, you're the best.
They're so funny cute. Together.
That sounds like the worst job ever. You'll do what he says and hope, you know, it's not a... Hope you don't get shot or whatever. It's like,
Okay. So this is Gotham Rooftops. This is kind of a cool level, but another issue I have with this game that I'm noticing... Back then it was really cool, but most of the environments are very... Kind of like Arkham Asylum, they're very bland. This game has an excuse, whereas Arkham Asylum did not, because it was a 2009 game. This is a 2001 game, and you can see the details not quite as good. The colors are very dark and gritty. Of course, you know, the show was very dark and gritty, but it didn't quite look like this. The buildings all had a unique personality to them, and there was definitely a splash of color when there needed to be. It wasn't just, like, boring game to look at.
Brown and gray.
Yeah. But of course, the red sky, I really like that about the new Adventure series. I thought that was really cool. Like,
cool.
Changing it up and doing their own little thing. And I'm using stealth mechanics right now. But, of course, they don't work very well. As you can see, I just dropped a gas pellet and I disoriented the guy, and now I'm going to handcuff him. Because you have to handcuff all the foes in this game, or they'll get up and attack you.
Wow.
Yeah. This was later reused in Batman Dark Tomorrow, but every time you had to handcuff a bad guy in that game, there would be a cutscene that would last like 2 or 3 seconds, and you had to handcuff everybody or they would get up. But you had unlimited handcuffs in that. The only reason I have unlimited ammo right now is I'm, of course, using cheats. See? You wouldn't have the electric batarang right now.
The cheat of being awesome.
Totally. And there's a super move right there. And again, cuffing the guy so he can't get out. So, I mean, yeah, this game definitely made you feel like the Dark Knight back then. I still think it's fun today. I'm a huge fan of the animated series cast and, you know, characters and settings. So this game was a big deal for me when the GameCube first came out. It was like, I played this game so much.
Wow.
That, you know, probably more than Melee the first, up until I beat the game a second time in December, and it was like, I was just obsessed with Melee before I went to college.
I wish I had this game now. It's like, yay, because I'm a big animated series fan, so.
Yeah. A lot of people complained about the first-person view, though, so you can actually get the gadgets and stuff. Because they didn't find a way to use the gadgets fluently like they did with Arkham Asylum. So before that, you had this first-person view mode, which hasn't really come back, but other than cycling through the gadgets forward and not being able to go backwards, it's pretty easy to get a handle on what you need to use. I'm actually going to tie up the guy using the net. That way we won't have to fight him at all. See? No handcuffs either.
Wow. It's like...
Yeah, pretty easy. Oops, I don't have my back grapple.
It's like a handcuff upgrade.
Yeah. Of course, when using cheats, though, you can't pick up any additional ammo and stuff like that. And sometimes health pickups don't even work either.
Sadness.
But I really like the music for this game because it doesn't really have the animated series music to it, but it captures the spirit of it.
Right.
Whereas, of course, the adventures of Batman and Robin on the Genesis went for the more techno music, which I don't mind the music at all. I think that the composer did a great job in that game, but again, doesn't have that Batman feel. It doesn't work.
Yeah.
Works for Gunstar Heroes, which the game is basically, you know, like, but it's not. Whoops, I forgot. Hang on. Switch! Alright. Nope! Oh well, I'm gonna have to fight him. Let's mess around with some of my other super moves. You can actually block in this game, which is pretty good. I love that move, that's my favorite. It's very simple to do, you just hit R and A at the same time.
Oh, cool. That is simple.
But if you... Or, excuse me, LNA. If you don't hit it precisely, though, you'll bring up Batgirl, and you'll have to talk to her, and it's
no.
Like you pull a Save by the Bell, and the game just freezes.
That's weird.
Like, time
yeah,
out.
It is Save by the Bell.
Report.
Blah, 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 blah. Me.
You know how, you know.
Yes. I know.
One of the things I mean, I love the Cape Glide in this. This is definitely my favorite level, but there really aren't any other levels like this in the game. This is the extent of how cool the game was, because most of the other levels, they change up the environment. It gets a little bit different. Each place has its own distinct theme,
mm-hmm.
But I just love the rooftop mechanic. You
yeah.
kind of revisit that with the SWAT like chase later, but it's completely different. Like, you're not, like, using your Cape Glide and going from one place to the next. You're just using the back grapple.
Yeah. Oh, I love the Cape Glide. It looks so cool.
It's awesome. And we can actually get a better view of how awesome Gotham looked back
yeah,
then.
Yeah, those buildings look... I mean, some of them look really familiar, especially the windows, like, with the animated series and stuff, the way it was drawn.
Well, I inspired our fan art background from this game.
Cool.
So yeah. I did some Photoshop tweaking and some animated series stills, and then changed the color of the sky and did some other stuff, and that's how we got what we had.
Yeah, that's awesome, Pete.
And I superimposed the CG models of these buildings in it. And they look pretty
cool.
Very cool. Yeah, I like the outcome.
That's awesome.
Boss battle. Kinda. She's not even tied up. She can get away.
This isn't what you think, Batman.
You're on a date, then? Looks like a kidnapping to me.
Like, well, go about your business. I don't want to disturb you.
Young love. Oh! You know what? See, you just... Ow. Yep. Face block.
He's like, stay away from her, Batman. She's my date.
Wimpy kick. I love that move. Never get tired of that move. Ow!
Wimpy kick.
Wimpy kick and punch.
They should call it that.
Now you have to handcuff him. See? I can't pick up any items. Aha! Beaten.
Yay.
Owned.
The Joker's after you.
You think?
He's got... He took my...
Toby.
Yes, Toby, my son. He took my son. He says he'll kill him unless I can pay him $5 million. I don't have that kind of money.
Are you sure he has the boy?
And how does he know that's not Harley by her voice?
He sent me this. Said yeah. If I didn't believe him, he would send... Would... Oh.
Exactly. You know what?
Take this.
She was fooling me. I didn't realize it was Harley. Oops.
Blonde.
What? You said that and I was like, what?
Oh yeah, there's also a score system at the end. And you always go back to the Batcave and chat.
Any evidence that Mary could come up with $5 million?
Have coffee.
No way, that's insane.
Joker's donuts. Insane, but not stupid.
Go for a bat donut.
Scones.
So what do we do?
We play along until we get to the bottom of this.
The transmitter you gave Mary last night. It's coming from Gotham Bridge.
Right.
And off he goes.
Up, up, and away.
No, that's Superman.
Oh.
Anyway, gamers, that does it for this episode. Thanks so much for watching. We hope you've enjoyed Batman Vengeance Part 1. Tune in tomorrow for the next installment as we head to Gotham Bridge, or the Brooklyn Bridge, or some kind of bridge in New Jersey. Whichever.
Whatever bridge it's supposed to be.
Gotham Bridge is falling down, falling down. My fair Toby.
That's right.
So, until tomorrow, gamers, God bless, happy gaming, thanks so much for watching, and we'll be seeing you.
See ya.